RPS 205 Superintendent Dr. Aaron Jarrett taking time out of his day. Dr. Jarrett, good morning.
Oh, thanks so much for having me. It's great to be here.
We're glad to have you along with us. This has been an interesting time for you, no doubt.
Yeah, this has been a really, really difficult time for our entire, frankly, not only our entire country, our whole world, but in the school district. We're doing everything we can to make sure, start off with, kids are fed and have meals and have just their basic needs taken care of. And then we've been trying to work our way up to get to the point where we have really high-quality instructional opportunities for students. So it's been a busy 3 weeks for us, to say the least, but we're just thankful we have so many great physicians and first responders and people out there working to keep our kids safe.
Yeah, let's talk about one of the first and most important things is, you got to have something to eat. That's what we need to keep ourselves going, and that's one of the first things you mentioned as far as making sure the kids were taken care of in the food department.
Absolutely. We have 8 different sites that are available throughout the community at different places in our school district, and we've just been blown away by so many other great community partners that have made sure families have had food. So this obviously, we want to serve the students in the school district, but bottom line is we don't want anybody in the community to run short on food, and we've just been blown away by how many great community partners are out there making sure families have food. We're happy to do our part.
Dr. Jarrett, I want to talk about remote learning. I have a high school teacher in my house, and I know we've been signing up for all sorts of teleconferencing efforts. I know you guys passed out some laptops to students. Where are you guys, RPS, in remote learning and getting everybody up to pace and what needs to happen, hopefully, in the next month and a half, 2 months?
Well, it has been a big, big undertaking, and I'm really grateful to all of our teachers and our staff and our district office team led by Heidi Detman. There have been so many people that have done great work here. And basically, what we had to do is find out a way to get about 15,000 Chromebooks out to students. We had to work with about 2,000 teachers who are in various levels of preparation for doing teleconferencing and posting lessons online, and over the last 3 weeks, we've been building that. So I guess there's an old cliche about building the plane while you're trying to fly it, and I think we've been doing a little bit of that. But boy, I just have been so thankful for everybody has really come together to make sure our students have quality learning experiences. So we're thinking we're going to be getting out around 8,000 more Chromebooks on Wednesday. People have a chance to sign, had a chance last week to sign up in advance. If we missed anybody with last week's second round of signups, we'll do a third round the next week. We want to make sure all of our students have what they need and all of our teachers have what they need.
You mentioned building the plane while you're flying it, and problems will arise. What unexpected, hiccups have you guys come across during this rollout?
Well, the greatest hiccup has probably been just the logistics of if we just handed everybody a Chromebook or a computer, it wouldn't have been as difficult. But we're really trying to make sure each student has a unique Chromebook that has kind of a digital signature to it so that we can kind of check it in and out. And also keeping social distancing, keeping our staff and our students safe and families safe while we're doing that. That has probably been the biggest lift of all the things that we've tried to accomplish. But boy, people have been really patient. They've given us the grace that I've asked for. We're confident, and we want to reassure people we're not going to run out of devices. But we definitely had some long lines last week, and we think this week we're going to be even better equipped to make sure everybody comes away that signed up in advance with a device.
It seems to me, Dr. Jarrett, you're dealing with a nice level of patience with parents and other people that you're dealing with, though, and all of us realizing this is all uncharted territory. We haven't been through this before, so there's no template to look at. There's no, well, last time this happened, here's how we did it. It's all, we're cutting from new cloth with everything we do.
Absolutely. I think typically you'd want to take a year or two to roll out a one-to-one distance learning protocol, and we're doing it in about 3 weeks, and the community has just been awesome. We've had so many great just people have been really patient, and this is about equity for our students. We want to make sure that students have the opportunity to take part in these lessons. We do have paper packets. And one of our next big challenges that we're going to need help with across the community is how do we make sure all the students that bring these devices home have access to Wi-Fi safely? It's not like in a typical scenario where you could head over to a coffee shop or a laundromat or something because of social distancing. So that's probably going to be the next phase of the work once we get a device in everyone's hand. Now that we have teachers that are doing a great job of putting digital lessons out, we've got those paper packets as a backup that are going to be available every Thursday. But we also feel like we're going to have some families that may need some assistance with getting onto that Wi-Fi.
Real quick, one last question here. Obviously, you know, proms and spring sports, all that stuff's getting canceled. One thing that I've been thinking about is AP testing that's supposed to start here pretty soon. What's the plan to get these kids their AP tests in?
Well, thanks for asking about that. The College Board has been wonderful. And what they did is they took what was a largely paper pencil in a big kind of big classroom, or in some cases in a big gymnasium kind of face-to-face test, and they found a way to make it an online open book, open note, 45-minute test that's going to be occurring in late April or early May or into mid-May, depending on when students take those tests. So, and they're really committed to assessing students on what they would have covered by March 13th or so. So there's a lot of review going on. All of our distance learning work is focusing in those classes on getting students prepared for that material. But I think the College Board did a great job of giving students a fair shot to earn those credits, despite what has been an unprecedentedly challenging set of circumstances.
It really has.
The College Board.
Dr. Jared, I hate to interrupt, but we're playing out of time. Thank you for taking time for us, and best of luck in what's going on with all of